just a couple miles east of the LAX airport, just off the 405 or the 105 at the beautiful SoFi Stadium in Inglewood. Coming up, we've got a good between the Atlanta Falcons and the Los Angeles Chargers. Fall is in the air, and the NFL season is in full swing, and we're underway here in week four. And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. Now the first carry for Cam Akers. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run, and let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They'll run here with Akers. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
And this throw incomplete. Now the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Intercepted. Picked off by Michael Davis. And a terrific return there. They're finally able to crowd him down near the 11-yard line. So far this season, this defense has had their issues against the pass, so that's a great sign for them to get the early pick.
Yeah, confidence builder for them, and an absolute shock for the quarterback, because he went into it, he saw the numbers we saw, he watched them on tape. I think he came into this one thinking this is going to be a big day, and it very well could be, but early in this one, advantage defense.
And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards to pick up there. Working with a 2nd and 3. Barkley, toss play left. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Los Angeles. Saquon Barkley. A 3-yard touchdown run. And the Chargers have taken a first quarter lead. Extra point good by Hopkins. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. A About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I'm hearing my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Here's a run with Akers on second down. And this one will go to the 28-yard line. Now, look, that wasn't a huge game, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake, and they've taken care of that early.
On first down, they'll stay with Akers on the ground. Tackle made there by the safety, Derwin James.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
After the pickup of five, here's second and five. Off the play fake, Peck. Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
They come up now, third and five, following the incomplete pass. Incomplete.
Looks like a second empty possession to start the game. It's certainly not the way you want to start when you're coming off of a loss last week. Every team talks about starting fast. They're hoping on their next possession, it can be a delayed fast start and get them going.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And it'll be Charger football here as they take over. The Charger drive about to get going. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you run into big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now. Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
A first down carry for Barkley. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. Rashawn Slater, first round pick in 2021, guilty there. They're backed up here with a first and 20 now after the holding penalty. Here's Herbert. This one goes out wide for Barkley. And he's got some space here. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A big play there on the catch and run.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. Justin Herbert looking to pass. He dumps it off to Barkley. They get six. That'll leave them with third and four.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. So this will be spotted on the midfield logo. It's a 58-yard attempt. And I tell you what, he got it from 58. That had lots of leg behind it. That also a career-long kick for the veteran, Charles.
Yeah, how about what he just got done there? We always knew he had a big leg. But how about everything coming together perfectly on that one? Great leg swing, and bang that one through.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And it's been a rocky start for them thus far. They had the turnover and then the punt on those first two drives.
So there is optimism because they've improved, right? Turnover, you just noted it.
Punt's better than the turnover.
The punt is better on the second one. Now they're hoping to turn it into first downs and hopefully points.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. 10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. Second and five. Off play act, under a heavy rush, and down he goes. It'll go as a loss of about six, and now it brings up third. I don't care if you're taking it around one, you're undrafted, whatever. As a rookie quarterback in this league, you're going to have games where you face adversity like this.
Lessons. All the time you're going to face these lessons. The key for this guy is, will he be able to bounce back in the next one? Because right now, this has not been his game.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first three drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
Fair catch called for and taken right near the 30-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Charger drive about to get going. They'll start out on the ground. It's Saquon Barkley. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Here's Herbert. Being chased out left. That's going to be caught by Richardson. But he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. They'll run on first down. Barkley. And brought down, but able to get it to their 30-yard line.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash too.
And he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. That's what we're used to seeing. Plays like that, why he's number four in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary.
And he takes it in for a Charger touchdown. Saquon Barkley with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. The Chargers, they're able to widen their lead. With the extra point, and that makes our score 17-0. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. They're down 17-0, really needing to find that offensive spark on this drive as they have it with a first and 10. And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down.
They kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, and he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
So following the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 25. Looking to throw. Peck flush to his right. Open target here. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. They'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job, but they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
It's pretty easy to overlook the fullback when you're making your assignments defensively in the pass coverage game. But in this case, they made him pay for that oversight and picks up a nice gain.
So the 14 yards actually takes him from 143 to the other for 1st and 10. On the counter, this is Akers. And he's dropped right at the 40. Gain of 3. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we were watching this in the film room, when you clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle him. That's what you're looking for.
Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me in this booth.
Yes,
and he's miles away and smiling.
And happy. When you're lateral to the line of scrimmage, linebackers keep those shoulders square so they can go up and down. But when it's time to go, turn your shoulders just like a running back. Get through the line and hit the runner in the backfield.
Man open, that's Jamar Chase complete. And he is going to have a Falcons first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there, and they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
Now a play fake here on first down. They'll roll him out right. He's going to go up top for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Darius Slayton, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons get a bit closer. Now, I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. So they called it a touchdown originally, and this will stay a touchdown after the video review, so they had it right. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Kenny Nwangu now out of his end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Charger drive about to get going as they'll take over with just under a minute left to play until the break. A play fake, and now Herbert to throw. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. A big play there. 83 yards. And the Chargers are able to strike quickly to add on. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that'll make this a 3-score game now. The lead moves to 17. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And this will not be brought out. It's a touchback. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And with a three-score deficit staring them in the face, they might have to press the issue here and try to get points out of this drive. Akers has got the first down and then some. And he'll get this all the way up to the 42-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. Off the play fake. Peck. He's going to fire one deep over the middle. A rifle's one, and that's going to be intercepted. Derwin James with a pick. And the Chargers are going to get the football here as he gets this up to the 38-yard line. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half, I mean, that just didn't happen. Throw left side complete. That's Richardson. And the Chargers going to signal for the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. First down, it's Herbert, and that's incomplete. Clock stops with 10 seconds left. Just his second incompletion so far. He's 8 for 10. I think he'll take 80%.
There's no doubt that he will, but if you're the defensive play caller, you better circle what you just dialed up on your play sheet and come back to it because you just caused an incompletion. You need a few more of those.
Eluding the pressure right. And that's complete to the right side. It's Allen. And he gets this down inside the 35 before going out of bounds. And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash and call it an even 50 yards. Hopkins' kick is good. And that will do it for this first half. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Chargers will start the second half with the lead and the football as we're underway in the third quarter. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
From the 27, Herbert. And that is incomplete. That one doesn't find its target, but all in all, he's been much sharper this week. He was under 50% a week ago, and now he's up over 70%.
But you know it's standard for quarterbacks and receivers get together for a little extra time each and every day in practice. I get the sense they got together for a lot of extra time this week to try and improve that passing percentage, and it's worked out quite well.
And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on fourth down. On is the Chargers punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. A 40-yard punt, 1 yard on the return, and the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here. Second down, they'll go with Akers again. And his rough afternoon continues. He's going nowhere again. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. Off play action. Peck. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And that's caught inside the 35. And he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line. It's a big play there for Atlanta. And you need a big play? Go to your big play guy.
Listen, that's football 101. When you have to have it, you expect that guy to step up. A lot of people call these receivers divas. Sometimes just leadership when they get in the huddle and say, get me the ball, I'm about to make a big play.
They'll run on first down with Akers. He'll get about 6 there as he takes this one down to the 24-yard line.
It's interesting, going into this game, there was so much talk from both sides about who would control the line of scrimmage. I think we've seen who has it in this one so far.
Well, they bottled him up. He's barely averaging over 3 yards a carry right now. 6 yards on that last play. Here's 2nd and 4. They'll go again here with Akers. And not able to break away this time as they're going to stop him right around the line of scrimmage. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. Catch made by Slayton. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. They stop him for only 3 that time, and that'll bring up 4th down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. They'll run for it with Akers, and he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. The Falcons go for it, but it doesn't work out. And the Charger defense stands tall, and they get the football back. The Charger drive about to get going, and they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. On first down, Barkley. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Here's 2nd and 9, just 1 yard on that last run. Back to throw here, Herbert. Over the middle, complete. It's Richardson. And that's going to be good for another first down as the tackle's made at the Falcons' 45-yard line. Final minute now of the third quarter. They'll run on first down. Barkley powers through him. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure you're back. You spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Trying to force it to Allen, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 25. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
And he takes it all the way down to the 15.
Let's go.
It's a big play there for Atlanta.
But they didn't ease into that drive right out of the turnover. They go for the big shot downfield and hit it. A lot of teams have that opportunity, but not every coach is going to green light that type of a play call. I love their aggressiveness.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. From the gun, Peck. Darius Slayton with his second touchdown of the game, fourth of the year. And the Falcons have got it back to a two-score game here in the fourth. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that cuts this lead down to 13. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
And don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a two-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here. If they
That's caught inside the 20. Touchdown, LA! His 10th touchdown of the season, second of the game. And the Chargers look like they're going to get back in the win column as they extend their lead here in this fourth quarter. And they'll have Herbert try and throw for it. Escaping the pressure right. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth. So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is. I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. He's going to loft one deep left side here. They've got his man complete. And he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. It's a big play there for Atlanta. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. To throw. Peck. And he'll go right back to Chase. That's caught again. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down. Brings up second down.
On the handoff, running left is Akers.
Oh, a good move at the five. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the one.
44 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
So a decent deficit at this stage in the second half. Four down territory?
No doubt about it. There's not a chance that he hasn't looked ahead and said, okay, if we gain yardage on this play, this is what we'll do going forward. If we lose yardage, this is the play call that I'll have ready.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Akers.
Able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action, throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
To run with Akers,
and he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta.
Cam Akers,
his sixth touchdown of the season, and the Falcons cut into that lead.
Two able to connect on the extra point, and the lead will be cut down to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Charger drive about to get going.
Well, there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking...
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And all the way in for a Charger touchdown. Saquon Barkley, 75 yards. And the Chargers have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
Hopkins with the extra point, and the lead now to three touchdowns at 21.
Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away.
And it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
Set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line.
And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss.
They go play action here on first down. And the Chargers rush is going to get there. Down he goes. Uchenna and Wosu got the sack there.
Boy, that's tough, Charles. First play of the drive, you're hoping to stay ahead of schedule. You take that huge sack, and now you're facing second and a mile.
And the entire time, you're probably thinking the same thing I was. Either get rid of the ball, safely, of course, or go down. The yardage he gave up on that play, that's going to be tough for them to make up.
54 yards on the ground for him so far.
The Falcons on third down, 3 for 7 so far in this game. This is third and 11. Operating from the gun, Peck.
Pressure comes, and down he goes. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They come up on a fourth down situation with things not looking particularly rosy. So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. A 40-yard punt, 5 yards on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Charger drive about to get going. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. With the late lead, Herbert's going to throw it. He's going to take a shot right away for the end zone. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. A great play there. 52 yards. And the Chargers find a way to stretch their lead. Extra point good by Hopkins. And that'll increase their lead to 28. Following the touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. Let's just be frank. They're playing
all that's left because victory now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now. And if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. So from the 36 now, first and 10, looking to throw. Peck. They'll set up the screen here to Akers. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Try to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. This one taken in by Cephas. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at him and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
That ball caught by Slayton. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the game. Fake. Peck. This complete to Martin. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Again, he'll drop to throw.
Throwing left side, it's complete. And he will reach the 8-yard line before going out.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding, probably his agent, as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Cam Akers with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Falcons get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that'll cut the lead back down to 21. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. Nwangu now from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel-down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now, to put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
On second down, here's Barkley. And up to the 35 before they're able to knock him down. And what are the whistles for? Timeout. So they'll stop the clock here in a game that's been decided in the closing seconds. Now Saquon Barkley. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Now we'll get whistles, and they've signaled for a timeout. Not sure I see the logic in this, but we'll get a stoppage anyway with 5 seconds remaining. They're going to pass here with Herbert. Flushed out right. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win. And put up the amount of points that they did. Why were they clicking on off?
From the devil got you piping hot. this up and you get screwed and chopped, no Michael Watts. When I was 10, I knew I should have been on rap a lot. Think like Jay Prince and I do more than just rap a lot. Listen, I went and got my digits up. Listen, your favorite, bruh. Listen, you don't want no trouble, cuh. The 25th, I got a meeting with the governor. That's real rap a lot, no cap a lot. I used to from Farron down to Camelot. I used to whip a in my granny's pot. She asked my friends, was I? They said, nope, he not. The mind to a praying woman. The truth's a heavy burden and it's weighing on me. Red dog has caught me slipping with the wailing on me. I went to calling out for Jesus like a reverend, homie. Chalked it up to sin, took it on my chin. Gotta take some L's if you wanna win. They took a, but then take a sin. I didn't even have no re-up I could re-up with. Had to rob another just to re-up. Pray to God it in his heart he find forgiveness for me. It was nothing personal, it was just business for me. When I got on, I paid him back and told him was ugly. I'd rather ask forgiveness like 100 times than be asking for permission in a beggar's line. Cause of who I be and check out how I tend to mine. I got a partner who don't eat no poke at dinner time. But let you act like you gon' ever hurt or injure mine. He have your woman, then that's my dinner time. I keep my eyes on glory till the devil get behind. Now bear in mind the devil made me offers I decline. We not aligned, not combined, I am not confined to any.
Touching on the back. What you see is good intentions. It's the cloud in his.